Hello and welcome in our YouTube channel Metallurgical Facts. In this video, we will try to understand how to calculate gate score. So we will see how we can calculate our own gate score. And after qualifying gate exam, we will get one scorecard which is valid for 3 years. And in that gate scorecard, they mentioned three things. That is number of candidates appeared in that year, and the qualifying marks for every category. So qualifying marks they will mention, and one more thing they mentioned that the validity valid up to. So they will mention that this scorecard is valid up to how many years. Okay, so this is basically 3 years, and they will also mention the gate score out of 100. And they mention the score gate score out of 1000. Okay, so we will see how to calculate the gate score out of 1000. Okay, and also we will see the second thing, we will see that how to calculate the percentile. And in some exams they ask that how much percentile is in your gate exam. Okay, so we will see how to calculate percentile also. So there is a formula given by gate authorities for the calculation of gate score of all papers. So here I am writing that formula. So that formula is S is equals to SQ plus ST minus SQ and multiply by M by M minus MQ by MT minus MQ. So basically we use bar on empty. Okay, so this is the standard formula by which we can calculate the gate score for every papers. Okay, so now I am writing the terms, what are these terms and what are these terms used, the meaning of these terms. Okay, so this S is equals to, basically this is the gate score we want to calculate. Okay, so this is the gate score of the candidate. Okay, of the candidate. So this value we want to calculate. So this is the value S. Okay, the next thing is this SQ value. Okay, so this SQ value, that is 350, that is predefined for the for the calculation of gate score. Okay, so this 350 is already assigned assigned to MQ, those who are qualifying, those who are writing this exam. Okay, and this ST is equals to, this is basically 900, and this is also assigned. This is the gate score assigned for MQ. Okay, and we can write like that, this is assigned MQ. The M value, what is M? M is the marks obtained by the candidate in that paper. Okay, so this is the marks obtained by the candidate in the paper in which the candidate appeared. Okay, so we will see one example for calculation of this also. Before doing example, we will see the terms used. Okay, so this MQ is basically the qualifying marks. This is qualifying marks for general category. So this is general category candidate in paper. Okay, so this is qualifying marks, or we can say this is cutoff marks. Okay, so this value depends on, most of the cases this is this value is 25. In all other branches, in metallurgy branch, this value or we can also calculate this value by mu plus S value. Okay, so this mu is basically the mean, and this S is the standard deviation. This is the standard deviation of the marks of all candidates. So this is the marks of all the candidates, okay, who appeared in that paper. ओके सो विच एवर इज द लार्जर वी विल पुट दैट वैल्यू इन एम क्यू. ओके सो इन मोस्ट ऑफ द ब्रांच फॉर मोस्ट ऑफ द पेपर्स द 25 इज असाइंड, बट फॉर मेटलर्जी मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम दे यूज म्यू प्लस एस दैट इज मीन एंड स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन, द सम ऑफ द मीन एंड स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन ऑफ द मार्क्स ऑफ द ऑल द कैंडिडेट्स अपियर्ड इन द एग्जाम. ओके सो वी डिफाइंड एवरी टर्म्स. नाउ द वन वन टर्म्स लेफ्ट दैट इज एम टी बार. This empty bar means the mean of marks. This depends basically on students' marks. Okay, so the mean of marks, this empty is basically the mean of marks of top 0.1% or top 10 students, top 10 of the candidate. Who appeared in exam. Okay, so this is the mean of the marks. Marks means the marks that a student gets out of 100. Okay, so the mean of the marks of the top 0.1 percentile or top 10, whichever is larger. So we take always for larger values. Here also we can see that 25 or mu plus s, whichever is larger, we will put that value. Okay, so now we know this is the standard formula for calculation of GATE score. So this s is the GATE score we want to calculate. This SQ value is the 350 already assigned by the GATE authorities, and this ST and SQ is also. So this ST is also 900 assigned for the GATE score for calculating the GATE score. This M value is the marks obtained by the candidate in that paper, means out of 100 this value will be also out of 100, sir. Then this MQ is qualifying marks for the general category candidate in the paper. So I already defined that how to calculate MQ value. There are two ways of calculation of MQ, and this is empty bar. So this is the mean of the maximum mean of the marks of the top 0.1 percentile, top 0.1 student or top 10 candidate who appeared in that paper. Okay, so for metallurgy branch, we can calculate the GATE score by putting all these values here. Okay, so now we will see the example how to calculate this GATE score. So I am writing that formula again. That is, S is equals to SQ plus ST minus SQ, and this M minus MQ, MT bar minus MQ. Okay, so I already described everything in this formula. Now I will assume some values from my side, and we will try to calculate the GATE score, that is S value. Okay, so SQ is predefined, so SQ value we will take 350, and ST is also defined, so this is 900. 350, that means the general candidate who will appear in an exam, they will get 350 minimum score. Okay, so they will get 350. And this ST is equals to 900, and this M is what the marks obtained by the candidate in paper appeared by the candidate. So suppose I got 48 marks out of 100, so I will take it 48, that M value. And this MQ value is basically 25, or we can say mu plus S value. So for metallurgy branch, most of the time that is not followed. So they follow the mu plus s values because the number of students appeared in that exam is very low. Okay, so we assume that the qualifying marks for the candidate is 40 out of 100. Okay, and this empty value, that is mean of 100, sorry, mean of 10 students or 0.1% of students. So suppose this mean value MT is equals to 80. So now we will calculate this S formula by putting this all value. So we will put these all value here, and we will calculate the GATE score. So we will calculate GATE score. So now we will put this value, SQ is equals to 350 plus this ST 900 minus 350, and this MQ, this M is equals to 48, and this MQ is 40. This MQ will be always less for calculation of your GATE score. Okay, and this MT is suppose 80, and this MQ, sorry, this MQ is 40. Okay, so from here we can calculate it easily. Okay, so this will come 550 and this will come 8 by 40. So here, from here we can do like that. This is 350 plus 1110, so we will get 360 and 460. Okay, so this S means the gate score I have gained is 460 for 48 marks. Okay, so we cannot calculate this gate score by our own because we don't know few of the things from on this in this formula. Okay, so like this value we don't know what is the mean of the value, and this qualifying marks we cannot guess most of the time for metallurgy branch because we don't know mu and s value of all the appeared students. So we can have a guess by assuming these values, but we cannot know exact values of these terms. Okay, so we cannot calculate exactly, but after getting the gate scorecard we can verify whether it is right or whether it is not correct. Okay, so this is 460 I got, and now this 460 is gate score, and in few of the exam they asked to calculate in percentile. Okay, so suppose for this 460 I got rank 500. Okay, so for I got rank 500, so I will calculate the percentile of this rank. Okay, so now we will see the percentile calculation. So there is a simple formula for calculation of percentile. So in most of the exams they ask the percentile in gate, and in gate scorecard they don't mention the percentile. So how we can calculate the percentile from gate rank? So we know our in previous calculations we know our rank is 500. Suppose 500 is my rank, and the percentile we not need to calculate. So the formula for the percentile is number of candidates appeared in gate exam in that year. Okay, minus of your rank, that is my rank or the rank you want to calculate for calculation. Okay, and by number of candidates appeared. Okay, so this is basically same values. Okay, so suppose if you will get your gate score card, you will see the number of candidates appeared in that gate score card. Okay, so suppose here I am assuming that this number of candidates appeared in exam is 3000. Okay, so in most of the time in metallurgical engineering branch there may be 3000 to 4000 students appear for gate score gate examination. Okay, so the number of candidates appeared in that year, that is 3000. I am assuming for the calculation my rank is 500 and the number of students appeared, that is 3000. So I can calculate from here. So this is 25, 3000 into 100. So from here we can say my percentile is 83.33%. Okay, so this is how we can calculate the percentile from gate rank. Okay, thank you guys for your attention. I hope this video will be useful for you, and most of the students have doubts that how to calculate the gate score card gate score and how to calculate the cutoff marks, how to calculate the percentile value. That's why we created this video. One of our followers also requested for creating this video, so we created this video for them, and I hope this will be useful. Thank you. Subscribe our channel and press bell icon to get notifications.